What is a middleware? What are the most used middleware in robotics? ROS, YARP, which one is better? We'll dive into this right now. Middleware is the software that enables communication and management of data in distributed application. But what's distributed application? It's an application or software that runs on multiple machines within a network at the same time. By machine, we mean a computer, doesn't matter if real or virtual. Middleware operates at the level over the data transport services, that's TCP, UDP, but below the API, application programming interface. In this more specific sense, middleware can be described as the dash in client-server or the tool in peer-to-peer. Middlewares are fundamental tools in robotics. They're used to integrate multiple heterogeneous sensors and actuators, as well as providing general purpose modules for key robotics functions like kinematics, navigation, and planning. So if you think of the robot data as its nerve impulses, then the middleware is the nervous system. The two main robotics middlewares are ROS, Robot Operating System, and YARP, yet another robot platform. They are the main frameworks for research and development on robotics platforms and are deployed in hundreds of robots worldwide. ROS was primarily developed by the Willow Garage in 2007. It was first conceived to support a peer-to robot from Willow Garage, which is in fact a common example of usage of the majority of ROS modules. It's grown so exponentially since then that it turned into the most popular middleware in robotics. Now the number of robots that are partially or totally supported and configured over ROS has widened significantly. In addition to the large set of libraries, interfaces and utilities, ROS provides several state-of-the-art mobile robotics and motion planning algorithms. The basic communication objects in ROS are topics that send messages over the network. ROS 2 is also available, which is a new version of ROS that's under heavy development. YARP is a bit older than ROS. It was introduced in 2006. And it's been more used in the domain of human and robots, where skills such as visual and tactile perception, human-robot interaction, dexterous manipulation, and leg locomotions are central. Whereas ROS has a higher focus on mobile robots and provides more tools on navigation, depth perception, and planning. Its main showcase is the ICAP robot. Recently also the robots Common and VZ have adopted it, and the basic communication objects in YARP are ports that send bundles over the network. There's no better among ROS and YARP in general. They're both still under active development and far from providing a complete set of functions for general purpose robots. However, ROS is more popular and supports more robots. They also can be used together. For this, there are frameworks that enable communication between existing YARP modules and ROS nodes. The communication between the different applications is done by connecting YARP ports and ROS topics through code-generated YARP bundles. Well, that's it for this video. In the next videos, we're gonna see some examples on how to use YARP and ROS. And see you next time!
I hope you guys liked it. If so, hit the like button, subscribe, ring that bell so to know when more videos like this are out. It helps us out so much. I'll see you there.